Praise the Lord. The Bible describes him as a great man. A great man that cannot publicly bring out his hands before great people like him, because there is an impediment in his life. Although he's a great man, but there is something lacking in him, that he cannot exercise himself well. He cannot come out openly and present himself before kings and honorable men like him. The greatness of his life has been frustrated by a matter that is in him. Praise the Lord. Church, if you want to pray for revival in your life, because revival starts from you. Before it spreads abroad, it begins personally with you. Today, you are meant to be a great man. There is no born again, no one that Christ dwells in his life that is not a great man. I hope you know it. But the Bible is saying, there are so many great men among us, but there's a problem in our lives. Several of us today have problem. Although we are great, yet there is problem somewhere in our life. Maybe it may be a lie. The leprosy in Naaman may be a lie in your life. The leprosy in Naaman will be lost in your life. The leprosy in Naaman may be that you are a hypocrite. You are a pretender. The leprosy in Naaman may be that you are born again, yet you have not had Jesus in you. It's possible that someone can be preaching, but Christ is not in his life. Praise the Lord. Church, we want to pray. I'm not telling you this thing. I didn't come to preach, but I want to explain something to you. This man is a great man, but his greatness could not work out anything in him. Any day, any moment, in his bedroom, whenever he removes his clothes in his bedroom, every day he removes his clothes, he comes to the reality that there is something wrong with me. Hallelujah. Any day he comes personally and sits down with the Bible and comes to the truth, he will discover, although all this acrobatic life I'm living, yet there is not yet Jesus in my life. When the reality comes, he will know that there is something bugging his life, something in you that has separated you apart from great men like you, that you cannot be able to stand out outwardly in their presence, because something is wrong somewhere in your life. There's something that is pulling you, no matter how you're preaching, no matter how you are carrying the Bible, yet there is something that is a leprosy somewhere in that person's life, in that brother's life, or in that sister's life that needed to be cured. Jesus will cure that leprosy today in Jesus' name. Amen. At times when you sit down, you know that there's something wrong somewhere. Some people that are married, some will sit down alone one day, they will remember that there's something wrong with my marriage. There's something wrong with this relationship. There's something wrong with this man that is preaching in the altar. There's something wrong with this brother that is the prayer leader. There's something wrong with this sister, the way she dresses, the way she speaks, the way she behaves. Something is wrong somewhere. We want to go for healing. We want to go to the place of healing this morning. You were told yesterday that it is a fallacy for someone to have Christianity without the power of God. In fact, the Bible says in the book of Mark, chapter 16, verse 7, they say, they that believe in me. It did not say they that are pastors. Is it not so? He said, they that do what? How many believe in the Lord Jesus? Is it not everybody? He said, those, that brother at the back, that little child, that believe in me. These signs shall do what? Follow them. If you believe in me, the works I have done, greater than that shall you do what? Do. There are signs that show. There are things that speaks out expressly that this person believes, belongs, is a child of God. He belongs to Christ. This sister is not of the world. There's something in him or her that singles him or her out that she belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ. But this man has a leprosy. What is your leprosy? We want to pray. What is the leprosy in your life that hinders revival? What is the leprosy in your life that the power of God cannot come into you? That the Holy Spirit cannot rest in your body? That your body cannot carry the Lord Jesus Christ? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I want someone to open to the Bible. John chapter 14. Can someone stand up and read for us? Verse 21. John 14, 21. Naaman is a great man, but with leprosy in his life.
He that have my commandments and
keepeth
them.
He is he that loveth me.
And he that loveth me shall be loved
by my Father.
I will love him.
I, Jesus, will love him. Jesus Christ cannot manifest his life, his character, his power to a man that do not love him. We all carry the Bible, we all preach, but the character of Jesus is not found in us. We look for it. People are looking for the life of Jesus in his followers. Now read verse 23. Verse 23.
Jesus answered and said unto him,
If a man love me,
he will keep my words. And my father will love him. And me and my father will come unto him.
And make our house in his life. Sister, bro, I and my Father, we will make our house, our dwelling place, his life. That brother, that sister will become a dwelling place of the Almighty God. That there is no mountain that will be difficult for you to climb. That there is no power that can destroy you. Because imagine where Jesus and God Almighty is living in your life. That's the problem we have. That the leprosy today, that they can't live in us because we have not loved them. We have no genuine love. We have acrobatic lifestyle. We disgrace him. Our character shows that we come to church, behave like angels, and go out and talk and speak like demons. And that is leprosy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that is what? Leprosy. Our characters today cannot show the lifestyle of Jesus. Jesus said, I will come. My Father will come. We will live in him, sir. How do you feel when the Lord is living in you? How do you feel when the presence of God is upon your life? How do you feel? Tell me, what can withstand you? Is there anything that can withstand you? This is what the church is lacking to be, the presence of God. The Spirit of God, the abode that we are made to be the carriers of God's life, God's presence, God's power. That's what we are made of. We are not to carry sin in our body. We are not allowed sin to enter in the temple of the living God. heaven to kill this man in us so that they can take over. I want to let you know this, that there is nobody that is empty. Either you are occupied by Satan or you are occupied by Jesus. You know it? No ground is vacant. Nobody's sitting hand today is vacant. You come to church, you see deliverance are going in the church. Ushers, some choirs are going for deliverance. Why? Does this seem to be so? Is Jesus living in that life? Eh? Sir, it is time that we should sit down and ask ourselves the question, how Christ dwelleth in our life? Do we truly belong to Jesus? Naaman is a great man, but he had an impediment. What is your impediment? Let us not lie in this camp. Let's pray. Lord, oh Lord, take away this thing. Oh Lord, intervene. Oh Lord, my impediment is that I have not yet met Jesus, but I'm professing to have him, but he is not in me. If you read Titus chapter 1 verse 16, what did he say? He said they profess that they know Christ, but in works they deny him. They become reprobates. Is it not so? In every good works, nothing shows that there is Christ there. If the followers of Jesus will permit him to come and live in their life, let me tell you, you will walk to Asrock, Asovilla, without the security stopping you. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? If you go to the book of Bible, let's read that first, the last place, then we pray. Can a brother please open, or a sister, to Psalm 114? Open to Psalm 114, let me show you something that happened that made Israel to be what they are. Psalm 114, can you read for us from verse 1 quickly? And then we're going to end. We want to groan, we want to pray, we want to weep. The way we are, we have not complete. Something is wrong somewhere in our life. Why is it that our congregations are not genuinely born again? Sir, can you read, sir?
When Israel went out of Egypt,
Judah became his sanctuary. Israel became his dominion. Challenges, problems, looked at him and flew away. They did not be able to stop him. Jonah moved back. Barriers, difficulties, did what? Moved back. Mountains, stumbling blocks, they skim like lambs.
They hills like lambs.
They hills like lambs.
What
elects
you?
What elects you, O mountain? O sea, that you are driven back. Oh Judah, what is the matter? You are running away.
Oh, he's my man.
Why are you running away? What is the matter? Complete it.
Tremble on it.
By the presence of the Lord in the life of his own servant and his child. What is poverty? In the book of John, Bible makes us to understand very well, John 15 verse 7, he said, if my word abide in you and you abide in me, say, ask whatsoever you want and it shall be done. Ask what you want. Ask millions. Ask trillions. See that, my brother, it will be given to you because his word is living in you. When Jesus comes into your life, things are different. No mountain can withstand you. What ailed you, mountain, that you are skipping aback? Why are you running away from the presence of Israel? Well, because their God is with them. And they are moving, and every kingdom, nation could not stop them. Why is the land stopping us? Why are they resisting us? Because we have mixed blood. Our life is not complete. There is leprosy in the life of a great man, in the life of a great woman. There's leprosy in the life of a great woman that's supposed to command a harbor, that's supposed to lay hand on the sick, God will take the glory. That support not to lack anything good. Today we lack things that are good because the presence of God is not there. This morning, I want us to pray. Why will I put on my clothes and come out? Sir, if I cannot pray for my member that is sick and is healed, what is the reason why I'm a man of God? Something is wrong with me. My being a man of God is defeated. I'm playing games. If I cannot stand and lay hand on a possessed man will look at my face and remove his face. Rather than removing, he will look at me and started laughing. Demon will look at you and say, doing what? You are going, he is going his own way. Beg, leave this ones. This one, is there among them? Jesus, I know. Paul, I know. Who is this man that is on the road? I beg, come up on the road. And the possessed man will be going his way with confidence. You can't do anything because God is not in your life to do something. Where is your God? Why then do they hate and ask us? Where is our what? Where is our God? They laugh at us. When we carry big Bible, then they ask us, where is our God? Sir, ma, it is time for us to show them our God.
Yes, sir.
Israel, the Bible says, what energy? Why are you running away? Because our God is with us. And you can't defeat us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was ashamed of myself one day when my father, that is 80 something to 90 years, I was trying to sew my clothes at her and the needle fell down on the ground. I was looking for the needle. Then my father asked me, said, where did he fell? I said, that didn't hear. My father come and beat the needle and gave me. I look at him. I said, baby, that was the day my dependents come on better. My father can see and me, he get back to using glasses to see. I said, Lord, I will never use glasses. I said, it's my father can see with that glass to pick a bean. Me is looking for an head to pick a bean that I may see. Where is my God? I want to challenge you. Where is my God that can do all things? We sing the song, he can do all things. Where is your God? I want you to tell me. Tell Satan where your God is. Let us stand up and pray. This morning we want to pray. I want you to pray. See, it's not the type of prayer you pray and do anyhow. I want you to call on the Lord this morning. Where is the leprosy? Where is the leprosy in your life? The leprosy that's supposed to be removed in your life. That's the problem, that God cannot dwell in your body. That's why Jesus is not found in our life. That's why we struggle. We struggle to pray. We struggle to read the Bible. We struggle to live a holy life. We struggle to live a righteous life. That's the struggle. That's the struggle every day. Our life full of poverty, full of challenges. Let me say, whatsoever I tell you to do, do it. Because I know what he used to do in the house. I know what he used to do in the house. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. Whatever he tells you to do, go ahead and do it. When there is no food in the house, he can raise his hand and food will come. These signs and wonders shall follow them that believe in me. Shall be given to you. Oh Lord, there is no food for us this morning. Give us food and it will come. Heaven will answer you because you belong to him. I am not hearing your prayer. Heaven is not hearing you. I don't know whether you are serious. You did not come here for joke. You come here for revival. You come here to be made that you may go back and demonstrate the power and the presence of God. You come here that every impediment must be removed, that you may go back and then live as God wants you to live. presence of God. Why is the world in defeating us? Why is the angel of Satan is laughing at us? Because we lack the power. We lack the presence of God. We lack the spirit of God. We lack his spirit. He is not living in our body. I will make him a place of abode.
Thank you. prophecy in our life that the Lord will take them away today. That the Almighty God will roll away every leprosy today. That the Lord Almighty will heal us of every leprosy that will stand on our way. Naaman was doing great exploits, but he was a leper. Leprosy was standing on his way. There was a dirt in his life. There was a dirt in his life. Every dirt that is there in our life, that the Lord will take them away today. The Lord will roll them away today. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Like Naaman visited the servant of God, Elisha. He never returned back with his leprosy. Oh God, that I will never return back with my leprosy. I've come to dip myself in the water. I've come to dip myself in the water of the Holy Ghost. Oh God Almighty, I will never return back with my leprosy. Visit me today. Call upon the name of the Lord. Seek his visitation. The Lord is listening. The Lord. Whatsoever that will make you to go back the same, tell the Lord to take them away today. Tell the Lord to take them away today. Ask the Lord to roll them off from you today. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. With leprosy, you cannot be partaker of the commonwealth of Israel. With leprosy in your life, you cannot come to the assemblies of God's people. Can you be partakers of spiritual assembly? Can you be partakers of the purpose of God without leprosy in your life? Tell the Lord to take them away today. If God took away that of Naaman, he will take your own away today. Call upon his name. It's a moment of encounter. You will not be tired praying. Call upon the Almighty God that the Lord will intervene in your life, that the Lord will do a unique thing in your life, that the Lord Almighty will visit you, that you will return back with testimony. Never return back the same way he went to visit the man of God. He returned back with testimony. You are returning back today with testimony. you that the Almighty God will visit you in this meeting. He was a great man, ordained for greatness. Every evidence around the man was proving that he was indeed a great man. God had ordained him to be a great man. There was victory everywhere, wherever he goes. But Satan had put an impediment in his life. He was a leper. If the Lord did it for the man, he will do it for you. He will do it for you.
When God looked at it, he said, oh, how much I desire to use you, but because of this,
we are going to tell the Lord and say, Father, in this meeting, I will not live here on Friday, I will not live here on Saturday without you dealing with these issues. Please visit me. You visit that man. You please visit me. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Ask for his visitation. Never went all the way to the land of Israel. He left everything he was doing. He left his family. He took distance, journey, and went all the way to the land of Israel. He did all that was possible to make sure that he was healed of that leprosy. Oh, here is an opportunity before you today. Opportunity to be healed. God is giving you another opportunity to be healed of that leprosy. Why don't you call upon his name? Oh God, I will not live here without your visitation. I will not live here without your touch. I will not live here without your healing. I will not live here without your encounter. Call upon the name of the Lord. Yours could be anger. Yours could be pride. Yours could be lust. Yours could be immorality. You have some desire to come out of it, that this thing has held you bound. Call upon the name of the Lord, that God will deliver you. He that delivered the man, he will deliver you today. I want to be used on the forthcoming revival. I don't want to be left behind.
Something new in my life.